name is Peter Torkelsen. I work for Nonstop Sales in Sweden, a sales agent that's been around for the last 13 years. And we form part of a larger group that used to be called Millennium Media Group, that has a distribution end, a TV end, and also a localization department. 2 years ago, we were acquired by Turner Broadcasting, so now we're part of a much larger family. Expectations, I would say that I was very keen on coming here. When I got the invitation, I said directly, yes, of course, I'd like to go. For many reasons, I personally want to learn more about the Eastern Europe filmmaking, because I'm very interested and I'm also in charge of Eastern Europe as a salesperson. So to meet people and to talk about projects, that's always a good learning curve and educational, in educational aspects, it's always positive. But also, we do have 4 Polish films in our catalog, and we do have interest in adding on more. And knowing that there's very good filmmaking going on in Poland, we thought it was an ideal opportunity to come. At this very moment, I would say that we're looking for family and children content, so there's a lot of animation going on down here, so we're very interested in that. And also the typical action, crime, thriller, that type of films. Some strong emotional dramas would work well as well, but I guess the last 2 days I've looked a lot at animations and thrillers. The positive aspects or the impressions is that all filmmakers that I've been meeting have really concrete thoughts and ideas, and I'm impressed of how they've been pitching them. You can tell that they're very passionate about the project, which is very important. But more than that, I think they have a very stable and sound understanding on financing and also delivery plans and all those very important aspects of a film project. Because for us as a sales agent, if everything is just up in the air, it will never be a good thing for us. But, you know, the Polish filmmakers that I've met seem to be very clear on, you know, this is our process and this is how we will work and this is our aim. And that works really well for me. The projects that I've really fallen in love with in the last few days, I would say would have been maybe 2 thrillers and maybe 1 or 2 animations, more or less. But overall, I need to go home now. I need to reflect a little bit. I need to read through my papers and use the book as my guide as well, because it's one thing to read it on beforehand and it's another thing to read it afterwards. So I will do my homework and I will go through, and I have a lot of screeners and a lot of new information given from the producers. So I have a lot of things to go through, and I think I have an idea of what I really liked, but that can change, and that can, if I tell you right now that I have 4 projects in mind, it might be 6 tomorrow, or it might be 3.
Right.
We'll see. Quite a few of them were nervous about the fact that, you know, they were sitting in front of someone that will, you know, potentially, you know, cut their necks and say, oh, I don't like this or whatever. So I think a little bit more confidence would not be bad at all, because if you walk into a room with confidence, that sells a lot. So that's one thing, and that's easy to improve, really, if you try to think about it, to, you know, maybe smile a little bit more and be a little bit more confident about yourself. Obviously, there's one thing that, you know, the language factor. Sometimes it's really difficult to understand, and, you know, it's hard for the producer to express themselves. It can be hard for me too. I'm not a native English speaker, but, you know, it's important to try to, be, you know, really clear when you communicate. When you pitch a project, I think that one of my colleagues or competitors said something really wise this morning, and I don't know if she has said this in an interview, but you have 3 different type of pitches. You have the elevator pitch, the cocktail pitch, and the cigar pitch. And that's really good to think about, because honestly, you don't get that much time, and if you cannot explain your film within just a few sentences or maximum a few minutes, no one's going to want to listen. And I, as a sales agent, I sit there and I listen to you, explaining, you know, what your film is all about, thinking at the same time, I'm going to use those words explaining this to a buyer in the future. So of course, I'm a little bit concerned that if you can explain it really well and be very precise and concrete, then I will be able to do the same thing when I talk to the next level. So that's also a very important thing, that, you know, keep it short, keep it concrete, keep it very, be on top of the story. Because a story that takes 20 minutes to tell, it will probably take an hour to get into when you see the film. A producer who is looking for a new sales agent that he's never worked with before, I would say that he should come when he has financing, not maybe 100% secure, but you know, he's gotten somewhere into financing. And also when he has some sort of firm ideas on, you know, what the cast will be like, and maybe even a mood reel, or if possible, a trailer. Some people tend to make a promo on beforehand, before shooting the project. And if we can get, you know, a few things together really nicely packaged at an early stage, we'd be very interested in talking more. And then we want to read the script and everything. But, you know, to send out a script when it's still, you know, in doing the rounds, it's just the first draft or second draft, it's really, you know, wasting our time, because we get so much attention anyways from producers. So I would say you should contact us when you feel ready that you can pitch it really well. And that depends on the person, of course. Some people can pitch something really well when there's nothing, but some people need to wait until they have started shooting, or they have started, you know, the production, so we actually have some look and feel. And this goes for new producers or new relationships. If you have worked with a sales agent once or twice in the past, then I'm sure the sales agent want to hear anything from you at a very early stage, because it's all about, you know, starting to work out the plans for the future. And pre-sales is one of those aspects, but also to plan the lineup for 2014 or 15. So it depends. But I think the producer really have to be confident when he or she contacts a sales agent. I travel a lot, and I do go to co-production markets and meetings like this. And I must say, I really enjoy them, because it's great to meet all you fantastic people, but B, also find it very helpful for in the industry to have a chance to, during 2 days, just meet a lot of producers and be impressed and be disappointed and be all those things in between in a short period of time, rather than, you know, chasing down producers all year round and also being chased down by producers all year round. So that's one thing. And then where to find me? You find me in a lot of places, but I guess in a producer's perspective, I would say that maybe Berlin and Cannes are the two markets that are so long that there's always extra time for a producer's meeting or an extra chat, you know, on the side. At MIPCOM or AFM or Toronto, it's quite intense. Toronto could work out well as well, depending on how long you decide to stay there. This year I only stayed 4 days, so it was very intense, but next year I might be there for 7 days, so that could change. But yeah, Berlin and Cannes.